Hello, fellow hot doggers. This is the Hot Dog Professor. With an amazing amount of hot dog cart vendors starting up, there seems to be some struggling with locations and fears of saturation. Recently, a gentleman called me and said that he had recently purchased a new cart and was in a very small town, and there was already three other vendors he knew of and had heard of others coming soon. He was a bit discouraged, and I asked him how many convenience stores are in his town. He said he can think of only about five, but there could be more. So why would that many convenience stores be in your small town if the business wasn't there to support them? Do you see my point? The average hot dogger may get 80 to 150 customers a day. With a town of 10,000, your town could easily handle many hot dog cart vendors without ever becoming an issue of competition. It is natural to us humans to feel competitive. In a normal job, to sports, to hot dog vending, it's all the same. But usually these feelings are not warranted. It's simply human nature. Ever heard of the red car theory? You buy a red car and all of a sudden, it will seem as if you see red cars everywhere. In reality, nothing changed. You now just notice them because of the inherent competitive nature of humankind. Okay, I'm done philosophizing. Now, what about finding a spot? Unlike the story I shared earlier, some people are having difficulty finding a location. I'm going to share with you the sweet spots and locations, and also some tips on getting those locations. First, let's talk presentation. You are standing in front of the person that can approve or deny a certain location and say, "Hey, I got a hot dog cart and want to set up here in front of your store. Would this be okay with you?" Well, if your delivery of a request is similar to that, you can bet what the answer is. Here are some tips. First, don't call business owners or managers and ask them over the phone. Go see them in person. I know it requires more effort, but most people find it hard to say no when face to face. Over the phone, you are sure to get them into Amway easier than letting you put your cart at their place of business. Second, dress nice. Not suit and tie, but certainly wear a shirt and look presentable. I would dress in jeans and a nice shirt. Third, bring some pictures of your cart, copies of your licenses. I have even stopped by with some fresh hot dogs before, or even a coupon with a map to where you are located now. The fourth tip, change your pitch. Yes, I said pitch. You are selling them on yourself more than on the concept of a cart. Here is my pitch. "Hello, my wife and I have a small hot dog cart we operate to make our living. We set up in other locations and thought you might like us to set up here one day next week. We are licensed and insured and offer some of the best dogs you have ever tried. Our cart is fully contained and doesn't require any outside power or water. Kind of like those carts you've seen in the movies in the big cities. Your customers and employees will surely enjoy our visit. How would you like this?" Then wait for them to speak. Or alternatively, you could ask, "When do you think a good day would be for us to stop by for 2 or 3 hours? Then wait for them to speak. You may have to tweak this some to meet your needs or the conditions of the place you were offering to set up at. Well, I can already see. I need to have a second video. The second part will cover my favorite, most successful spots to set up, how to get these spots, and some extra tips. So don't forget to watch part two. Don't get discouraged. This is all doable. Rather easy once you get over the initial hesitation. Okay, be sure to check out all our videos at www.learnhotdogs.com and visit BensCarts.com for a new hot dog cart. Please don't forget to rate this video.